Hi guys, I'm Nidhi. In today's video, I'm going to be posting the flip through of my 2020 sketchbook. I had mentioned yesterday that I would be posting this video. If you have not checked out part 1, you can click on the white box which pops up on your screen right now. So, let's get right into the video. Okay, so for this drawing, I did not give it much thought and I just drew. I just colored it in. It does not have any meaning behind it, but I think it turned out looking really good. So I made this bulb and it's connected by this sort of green wire, I guess. And I drew these branches with these flowers, which were supposed to be cherry blossoms, but I don't know if they really do look like them or not, but it's okay. Over here, I just drew this sort of leaf, a newborn leaf, I can say, maybe a which is coming out. And for the leaf I used green, the same green I used here and for the sign over here, and I used brown for the branches, all of them. And for the flower I used pink. I just took the brush and just did something like this, and that's how I did that. And over here I used the same green and I put black first. Then for the bulb, I used light blue and then a darker blue over here and a bit of pink and a bit of yellow, of course. And over here, I used gray and I did not think that this would actually come out good, but I used a paintbrush and made these sort of black strokes and it turned out in a straight line, in a proper line, and it looked good in the end. It looks like I did it with pen, which I actually didn't. And I had not actually expected that, but it looks really good. I made this sort of paint splatter sort of thing. So I took a paint and I sprayed it around over here. I played around with different colors like green and blue and pink and red and stuff. And I did this on 30th of August, and I'll move on to the next one now. This is, I don't know what to call it. It was supposed to be a wave. It did not turn out how I expected it to turn out. I expected it to turn out a bit more better, but it's okay. I'll try better in the future and I'll recreate something like this and make it look even better. So for this drawing, I just was supposed to make a wave and the sky over here. So for the wave, I just used different shades of blue. I mixed and matched all sorts of shades and I colored it blue in different sort of shades. And there's a darker one and lighter one and a sort of even greener sort of shade. And then using a paintbrush, I just did this. I dipped into white paint and did this, and it looks like the sort of froth which comes up with the waves. And for the cloud, I was supposed to make this sort of orange. I was supposed to merge it into the sky as if the sun is about to, you know, set in a few minutes or something like that, but it did not turn out good. So I used my white paint and colored over it, which made it better than before, but still it was weird looking. And this is the sun, and I made two clouds over here. So I like how the colors came out in this drawing. I did not sign this and I didn't write when I finished this, so I don't know when I did this. I'll move on to the next one. Then for the next one, I sort of made this teddy bear drawing and I named this Inner Child because I was listening to one of the songs from BTS in Map of the Soul 7, which was Inner Child. So I listened to it that day only. So from that song, like the word Inner Child, I got this idea of drawing this teddy bear. I was getting this idea for a long time to draw a teddy bear, but I finally decided to give it the theme of Inner Child, and I drew different sort of stuff here. I drew this sort of box where you put on the shapes inside those sort of spaces over here. And I drew this teddy bear, which is blue in color, and it has those shines on his nose and eyes. It has a red ribbon on its neck, and it has the stitches over here. It's as if it's been hand stitched and stuff. And overall, I think it came out pretty good. I only used pencil colors over here, so it turned out good. I did this on 14th of September. Move on to the next one. This one was almost a disaster, but then I turned it into something good. It was supposed to be umbrella which had colors floating out of it or something like that, but then it turned out weird, so I colored it with my paints and made it into this sort of scene from The Wild where there's a giraffe into the distance and some birds and the sun and some mountains. This part still cannot be made proper, but the rest I think turned out great, and I like how the sky turned out, the color. One of my all pastel drawings, and my only all pastel drawings, I guess, in this sketchbook. I did not write when I finished it because I started it long back and then I finished it quite recently and I did not sign it. I signed it, but I did not write the date on it. So over here, these are these flowers which are pink. And I made this sort of branch which is a mixture of brown and red, and I made this butterfly over here. The butterfly did not come out pretty good, but I'm working on learning how to draw butterflies. I even saw a tutorial, but I like how this came out either way, and it looks like something, you know, like a child drawing, but still it gives it that sort of different look. And I like how these clouds even came out. Okay, so for this drawing, I just made these sort of triangle, large triangles. This one is not a triangle, it's a different sort of shape, but I made tiny triangles, and I used my colors, my sketch pens, I color them in. I used pink, blue, purples, and green, yellow, red, orange, and many other colors, and I just did this for fun, but it turned out like looking a sort of digital. I don't know why it looks like that for me, but I think it looks pretty digital, and I could easily turn this into a sort of logo or a banner of some sort, and I think this turned out really good. I won't say great, but I think it turned out really good. And I did this on 25th of September. This was supposed to be a drawing from a prompt, I guess, but it did not turn out that great. It was supposed to be an apple, but it did not turn out good because I used too much watercolor in this and it became a bit patchy, and then this part became too broad. So I've done another drawing of like this. I've done an apple using the same prompt list, but that one came out pretty good. I've shown that drawing in my 5 ways to fill a sketchbook video. So I'll move on to the next one. This one was also from a prompt list. It's a cake. The word was cake, but I decided to draw a unicorn cake because all of my drawings were this is a cute sort of drawing, and I've not done anything like that. So I like how this font is. As you guys can see, this font. And for this, it's a 3-tier cake or a 3-layer cake. So there's a sort of unicorn face over here with a crown on it. Then there's this sort of gift box theme cake. I don't know. This is sort of the cream sort of coming down. Cake, I guess that's what it's called. I don't know. This is the Zentangling one which I showed her in my 5 ways to fill a sketchbook video. So as I told you that I use colors, you guys can also do it black and white, but I just wanted to add a pop of color into it, and I'll try something which is black and white also. But I like how this one turned out. I use different sort of patterns, like these lines which are thick at some points and thin at some points, and these are the same thing except it's just lines and not thick and thin. And over here there's rectangles, there's triangles, there's hearts, then these sort of pink things, I don't know what they're called. And some I just colored them in because I didn't have any more patterns, but still, it turned out really good. You guys should try this out too. It's really relaxing and it also kills time if you're getting bored. And I did this on the 3rd of December, which is quite recently, in the previous month that is. So I'll move on to the next one now. This one was supposed to be based on one of the videos I saw, where there was this drawing a favorite perfume or something. I don't like perfume much, but I found this perfume when I was really small and stuff. I don't know where it is now, but I like the smell of it, and it was chocolate. I only like those smells, I don't know why. So for that, I just drew this perfume bottle and I colored it sort of purple color, which I used for the Cheshire Cat in my Inktober video. If you guys didn't check that out, you can check it out right now by clicking over here. And for the chocolate, I saw a picture on the internet and I drew that, and I made this a darker brown and this a lighter one, and then it's melting. I think this turned out really good, especially the part of the chocolate. I did not think it would turn out this good. And on to the next one now. This is my winter theme drawing. I made a video on this, guys. If you have not checked that out, you can click over here. For this, I used color pencil, as you guys might have seen in the video. And this is sort of a huge window, and I made this sort of glass door or something. Then there's these pine trees, or these sort of Christmas trees, if that's what they're called. And there's this snowman and the house. There's this girl holding her teddy bear and the sun. And this turned out greater than I'd actually expected it to turn out. I did not think it would turn out this good, but it turned out good. And it went out a bit over here, but still, that's okay. And I used black pen also over here, other than the color pencils. And I like how this turned out. I did not sign this because I was supposed to make this for the video, but yeah, I'll move on to the next one now. I did this one because I was getting bored and I had nothing more to do, so I just played around with colors, and this turned out, I like how this part turned out, but then I messed up over here because the colors, I added the colors in and stuff. I just found my watercolor tubes, which are quite old. I did not use them for a few years, like 2-3 years I guess, and I just discovered them. Half of them are dried out, but half of them, which are actually good, I used those colors, and I was trying to make a drawing, and some of the orange leaked into the mountain, as you can see. So I just used that for an element for the mountain. I like how this part turned out, and I did not, the water did not come out that great because the color didn't merge in, but that's okay. Over here, I used green and brown. I merged them in and stuff over here also, and I used a black to outline it. And I, for the sky, I used orange. I made different shades of orange and used them. And for the flower, I used a black pen and drew them, and then I colored them in with pink and green for the leaves. I didn't sign this either because I just did this and then I left, and then I forgot when I did this. So this one is my Christmas theme drawing, which I made a video on. Y'all can check it out by clicking up over here. So for this, I just used black pen and this glitter gel pen and color pencils. And I just made this Santa Claus line over here. I made two Christmas trees. One is sort of wild one, and this one is someone's house's one, and it is decorated pretty nicely, and it has a present down here. I wrote Merry Christmas down here using my gel pen, my glitter gel pen, and I drew a snowman over here. I did not sign this either because it was supposed to be for the video, so I did not sign it. I'll move on to the next one then. So this one is one of those. I recently found a channel called Amanda Rich Lee. You guys can also check her channel out. And over there were these sort of doodle with me videos, and I was inspired by them, and I made my own version of the doodle with me. So she had also done for the BTS album V, but I did the same thing, but I did it in my own way, or different way of course. So for that, I just wrote the title of the album over here using the same font as the album itself, and over here I wrote whatever was written behind the album or below the album on the cover of it. You guys can check it out too. So it says life goes on like an echo in the forest, like an arrow in the blue sky, on my pillow, on my table. Life goes on like this again. So over here is all the songs. So I got life goes on over here. Then there's blue and gray, fly to my room, dynamite, telepathy. Then there's the skit. So it's not a song particularly, but I just added it in. So because I still had a lot of space left, like over here there was a huge space left, but later on I realized I could make this bigger. So there's disease over here, there's stay over here. Then I made the logo over here. I made two mistakes over here for dynamite and fly to my room, and I used a paper to cover them up. I know it's very, I don't know, showing and stuff. You guys can see it, but still, that's okay. It's okay to make mistakes. So I learned from this mistake and tried not to make mistakes in the future projects. I didn't sign this because this was a sort of a song sort of list thing. I don't know what I should call it, but I didn't see it fit to sign on this, and even for the next one, which is another album I like, which is called Fatal Love. It's by Monsta X. So for this I use the same font the album has, the album cover has. I really like this font, so I just use the same thing. And these are all of their songs. Some of my favorite include Love Killer, Sorry I'm Not Sorry, and Beast Mode, Night View, Last Carnival. I like all of these songs, but these were some of my top ones. So unlike over here where I use only blue and black, I use red and black over here, and I think both of these turned out really good, except I made mistakes in the previous one, so this one turned out better than that one since I didn't make any mistakes here. I signed this one. I did this on Christmas, so I remember to sign this time. I did not sign over there because I didn't think it was fit, but over here I signed it still. And over here I used different fonts there too. So I guess that's it. I totally filled, I guess, these many pages with my 2020 drawings, and the previous part, of course, all of this, the remaining part is from 2019, and the rest is from 2020. I already done one drawing from 2021, and I guess that's it. Thank you for watching my video, guys. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe for more videos like this. And hit the notification bell if you want to get notified whenever I upload a video. And I'll see you next week in the next video. Until then, bye.